Welcome to this week's edition of Outdoors Online, a weekly webcast produced by the North Dakota Game and Fish Department. I'm your host, Mike Anderson. My guest this week is Game Warden Supervisor Jackie Lundstrom. Today we're going to talk about Operation Drywater. Jackie, what is Operation Drywater?
Operation Drywater is a national campaign to bring awareness to the dangers of boating under the influence.
Okay, when is Operation Drywater?
Operation Drywater for 2019 runs just after the 4th of July, so it's July 5th, 6th, and 7th. That time of year is usually picked because that's a high recreation time when a lot of friends and family go out to recreate because of the holiday.
Game wardens will be out statewide on busy waters and not so busy waters.
Of course. Game wardens will be out on the water statewide and bringing a little bit of education to some of their checks and letting people know of the dangers of boating and drinking.
Jackie, we're educating the public about this weekend.
Correct. And we've been putting out publications, whether it's online or on the television, through social media, trying to make sure that we contact all of those that are potentially involved with outdoor recreation.
And game wardens will be out on the water, whether it's this weekend or any weekend this summer.
Correct. Unless it's really nasty out there, we're trying to be on the water and making the contacts that we need to make.
What can boaters and kayakers, canoers, anybody out on the water, what can they expect to see?
During the week, that particular weekend, we try to make sure that when we make our contacts, whether it's a violation contact or a boat and water safety contact, that we always encourage a sober driver in a boat or kayak for that matter, to make sure that everyone that's involved in that boating experience gets back to shore safely.
Jackie, it's not legal to boat under the influence of alcohol.
Correct. You can have an alcoholic beverage within your boat, illegal to operate under the influence.
Okay, and that goes for kayak, non-motorized boats too.
Exactly, yes. Non-motorized boats, personal propelled boats, that is also applicable to them.
In the past decade, we've had fatalities on the water due to alcohol.
Correct. In 2017, we had 4 fatalities, boating related, that were all had alcohol in their systems at the time that they drowned. Also, we've had one instance up in Devil's Lake where an individual did die and another was paralyzed during a boating under the influence accident that occurred.
Okay, how does alcohol on a hot summer day, how does that affect somebody?
Wind and heat alone can affect a person in being hydrated, their balance, their mannerisms. And so if you add alcohol to that and you haven't had any water or something to eat that day, it's only going to enhance those issues and performance and balance and your visual context.
If you know you're going to be out on the water having alcoholic beverages, what should you do?
The best thing to do is to make sure you have a sober driver for that boat. Make sure that if you, as the boat owner and current operator, are planning on having an alcoholic beverage, that somebody else on your boat is capable of operating that boat back to shore or back to the slip to get everybody back safely.
If you're on the water and you see somebody that's been drinking and shouldn't be operating a boat, what can you do?
Anybody that's out there can certainly call 911 if it's an emergency situation. If they want to contact a game warden directly, they can certainly call 328-9921, which is the state radio dispatch center that dispatches our game wardens.
The overall goal for anybody on the water is
to make sure you get home safely. Enjoy your days out, have fun while you're out in the outdoors, but the bottom line is we want everybody to make it home safe.
A lot of good information, Jackie. Thank you. As Jackie just mentioned, 2019 Operation Drywater dates are July 5th, 6th, and 7th in North Dakota. For Game Warden Supervisor Jackie Lundstrom and the rest of the staff here at the Game and Fish Department, thanks for joining us for this week's Outdoors Online. We'll see you again next week.